consultant pediatrician and neonatologist at Hyderabad, and we are today on this forum to discuss a very important topic, which is a pandemic all over the world, and people are getting scared about this, and that is about COVID-19. We are getting a lot of patients in my OPD, and the parents are really scared with little cold and cough fever, and they are asking, "Madam, ye kya corona ho sakta hai?" And even we are seeing many people thronging the pharmacies, getting, you know, lot of masks, stocking it in their houses, buying lot of hand sanitizers. And even my friends have stopped eating Chinese product. And this was the time when I thought that we should come forward as doctors and we should give some valid and scientific information regarding this ongoing pandemic of COVID-19. So, Ashwin, we have collected like a few commonly asked questions which people have sent us through mails or they have asked us in WhatsApp. So we'll be discussing the most commonly asked question so that we can give you some right information about this disease.
Hi, I'm Ashwin. We are here to discuss about the coronavirus. In my neighborhood, I have seen many people wearing masks. They are afraid to go to schools, offices. Is this really necessary? What actually corona means?
Yeah, the corona is a virus which is causing respiratory illness, and in sick cases it is, you know, going for a severe pneumonia as well. But this is not the first pandemic what world has hit. In 2002 to 2003 there was a SARS which was again first started in China. So that also virus belonged to the same family of coronaviridae. Second, in 2012 MERS was there, which started in Emirates countries like Dubai and, you know, like Middle East regions. So it was named as MERS, MERS, Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, and that virus also belonged to the same virus family, that is coronavirus. And now what pandemic is hitting all over the world is again the same family virus called as SARS-CoV-2. This is novel coronavirus 2, which is again causing the same respiratory illness in all the people. So this first, all the three viruses has first origination of theirs in bat, and the animals were first infected due to this virus. From bat it spread to cats, camel, cattle and all other animals, and by eating this animal the people are getting infected. So it was from animals to human beings as the first transmission, and now the pandemic is because this virus is very rapidly spreading, and now the spread is through droplet infection from the sick person. So this is how the pandemic is going all over the world.
How does the corona spread? Is it an airborne disease or anything else?
More likely, it is a respiratory droplet infection, less likely through the air transmission. When a person having a COVID-19 disease, if he sneezes or coughs in front of us, the, you know, droplet, respiratory droplet and secretion may get deposited on our body. Maybe it is on our skin or our nose, in our throat or on our body surfaces, through which it enters in our body. The natural incubation period is 2 to 14 days, in which the person may be infected but may not show any symptom of the disease. After 14 days, then the person who is infected with COVID-19 may have symptoms. These are like simple flu symptoms like cold, cough, fever, and in later stage they may come with breathing difficulty, shortness of breath. So like 85% of the people will have milder symptoms and they may recover very early with a small amount of treatment, and only 15% will go for serious illness. And from that 15%, also the case fatality rate is less than 2%. So we should not get so much panic and we should not have so much havoc around these infections.
Who are more prone for the infection?
As for all the infections, like the people who are immunocompromised, the extreme of age groups, especially the older and debilitated patients, because of their low natural immunity, they are more prone for the infection. And second set of the people, again who are immunocompromised, if they are having diabetes mellitus or they have chronic respiratory illnesses or they have chronic cardiac condition, or the people on chemotherapy or any other immunosuppressive condition as such. So these people are more prone to get the viral infections.
What precautions to be taken if he or she is having COVID-19?
Yeah, this is a good question. You know, if person is having COVID-19 positive, okay, if he is suffering from the disease, first and foremost, he should take care that he is not going to spread the infection to others. So he should go into isolation, he should restrict himself to a room, and he should see that the droplets are not spread outside, okay, as far as possible. He should wear compulsorily a mask, so when he is sneezing or coughing, the respiratory droplets are not spread too far. Then second thing, the treatment would be symptomatic, he should take a good medical advice if he is having high grade fever or shortness of breath or cold and cough, the symptomatic treatment has to be given for that. Third thing, he has to take adequate rest, he should take good diet, you know, and diet should be rich in vitamin C because it is natural antioxidant which will boost our immunity. And major important thing is that he should use mostly the disposable things. So it is easy, you know, to dispose the things, and we have to take the advice from biomedical best people how to dispose disinfected things which is used by the sick patient. And the main care has to be taken by the healthcare workers who are in the contact with this patient, especially the doctor, the nursing staff and the close family members who are taking their care. So they have to use their personal protective equipment like their gowns, their face masks, caps and mainly the gloves. While touching any object touched by the patient, then we have to use the mask. And do not forget to do frequent hand washing. We have to do frequent hand washing at least for 20 to 30 seconds with the help of good amount of soap and water. If we are not having good amount of soap and water available with us, then we can use the hand sanitizer. But make sure the sanitizer should have
infected with the COVID-19. Are there any chances of the baby getting infected?
Yeah, this is one area which is still darker. We don't know much about this because there are very hardly any studies done on this aspect, and there are hardly any reports which are showing the correlation of mother getting infected in her pregnancy and outcome of the baby. But yeah, if the baby is small for gestation or if the baby is IUGR, they may have some birth defect. Okay, they may be born with some birth defect, but exact correlation is not yet proven. We don't have that many report, scientific report, to comment on this topic.
Okay. Can the mother breastfeed the baby?
Yeah, like if the mother is suffering from coronavirus infection or COVID-19 as a disease, the antibodies are not yet detected in the amniotic fluid of the mother, neither it is secreted in the breast milk. Even it was, you know, at the time of SARS and MERS, it was studied. But hardly any antibodies or viruses were detected in the breast milk. So yeah, it is generally safe to breastfeed these babies. Mm-hmm. There are no specific data on breastfeeding as well. But till the time we have not detected anything, any antibodies in the breast milk. So it is safe to breastfeed these infants. Somehow the pediatric age population are less affected with COVID. Right now, currently, although they are, you know, less on their immunity, we are seeing more and more cases in the adults and in the older age group people as compared to the pediatric age group. A lot of things coming on WhatsApp and Facebook and Twitter regarding uses of masks. But make sure that mask is not required for healthy people who are not showing any signs and symptoms of illnesses. The mask has to be preserved for the sick patient who is suffering from COVID-19, and for the health workers who are in care of doctors and nursing staff, and mainly the family members who are coming in close contact with these people. The mask is to prevent spread of droplets. Okay, when the person suffering from COVID-19 is coughing or sneezing, it will get spread on the surfaces. This is going to be, you know, prevented by the use of mask. So a normal healthy person who is not showing any signs of infection, he need not wear, there is no need to wear mask for him. If we are wearing mask driving and if your mask is coming down, again there is tendency that we will keep on touching our face, you know, lot many times. And this is how again we may contract the virus infection. So better healthy people do not use the mask and keep the mask preserved for really the needy one, the sick patients, the parents, their caretaker, doctors and nurses.
Is there any definitive treatment or vaccine available for COVID-19?
Treatment as such, we know for viral infections, there are no much treatment. It is all symptomatic. So one thing we have to do if the person is suffering from COVID-19, take adequate rest. In viral infection, more rest you take, the body will have more healing. So adequate rest for at least 8 to 9 hours per day. Then take good nutritious diet. The diet should be rich in vitamin C. You know, you can involve lot of citrus fruit in your diet, like your gooseberry, amla, oranges and mosambis, etc. So these foods are rich in antioxidants, so it will naturally build up your immunity in your body and they may protect us from viral infections. Third thing that what we have to do is frequent hand washing. This is the one major way to, you know, keep ourselves protected from the virus. And it should not be only with little soap and water for 5 to 10 seconds. But at least the hand washing should be done for minimum 20 to 30 seconds. and use good like medicated soap and water. If it is not available, we can use the hand sanitizer, but make sure that it contains minimum of 60% of alcohol content in that. Below that, it is not going to help much. Okay, and third thing, as we have already discussed, like keep yourself protected, use your mask, use your gloves when you are infected, so that other people are not getting infected with that, you know. And about the vaccines have not yet come in the market. It is under the phase 3 trial, okay. So it may take another 14 to 15 months for this vaccine to come in the market and, you know, be available for all of us. But I believe till that this virus will take back step and another virus will creep in. So vaccinations are still not available.
Madam, what are the final tips you want to give for the general population?
Yeah, see, protection and prevention is always better than the cure. Although the case fatality rate is less than 2%, we have to be more aware and more alert. First and foremost, avoid crowding. Okay, do not go to crowded places, avoid malls or movie theaters or any other social gathering per se. Second thing, avoid the international travel if it is not very urgent. Okay, try to avoid your meetings, conferences, CMEs as far as possible. Third thing, what we have discussed is, you have to keep yourself protected. If you are infected with COVID-19, use the respiratory mask to prevent the droplet being spread to others. Okay, and use like hand gloves. And the people, you know, who are coming in the contact with these people have to be more alert. They have to wear the personal protective equipments like gloves and then mask while using. And better to use the disposable thing for the patient. For our prevention, we have to, you know, do frequent hand washing. Because the respiratory droplets may be there everywhere. On the table, on the chairs, on the desktop, on the PCs, on the laptops, on the door, handles. It may be there in the tap faucet, toilets, wherever, light switches, whatever we are using on a daily basis, they may be infected. So the only thing we have to do is that hand washing at regular intervals. If you are touching this all object, go and wash your hand properly for 20 to 30 seconds with soap water. And these all things which are coming in our regular contact has to be cleaned properly. So surface cleaning for 3 times a day is very, very important. Clean all the surfaces like your tables, your chair, your door handle, your light switches, your faucets, and everything in which we are coming in contact with commonly has to be cleaned at least thrice a day with a good sanitizer.
Thank you so much, madam. Your talk was so informative.
One thing I wanted to add in this, along with this, take like good rest, eat good diet, you know, increase your immunity, keep exercising, and main thing, stop racism. It is not only like it is hit in China, so we have to, you know, boycott Chinese, eating Chinese things and all. And if some Japanese is coming and all, like see them, if the person is isolated, we have to boycott him and all. No, it is a very traumatic experience for the patient itself. So we as doctor have to maintain some professional privacy about their information. Do not put anybody's name or anybody's personal information on public forums like your Facebook, Twitters or WhatsApp. I'm seeing a lot of people putting all the names and their addresses on this public forum site, which is not acceptable. At last, they are human beings and nobody wants to get the viral infection for themselves. But unfortunately, they have got contracted. There is cure. 85% people are going to get cured out of this. And even 15% people, we have a lot of infrastructure. We have respiratory, things to support them. We have symptomatic medicine. So whoever is having symptoms of COVID-19, they should go to their neighboring government setup, get tested for them. And the testing is done by PCR technique. So if they are positive, get isolated, keep yourself hydrated, eat good food, take adequate rest, and take medication with the help of your doctor. Okay, so make your diet rich in vitamin C, take adequate rest, keep yourself happy, and take medication on time. Keep healthy, be healthy, be strong, be safe. Thank you. Bye.